Suppose that R is the finite region bounded by y equals x plus 1, y equals x plus 4, x equals 0, and x equals 4. Looking at the graph below, this is the finite region R. We're asked to find the exact value of the volume of the object when rotating the bounded area about the x-axis, which indicates we're rotating about the x-axis, which is here. Before we go over our notes, let's look at this in 3D. On the left, we have the bounded region R. When rotated about the x-axis, we have the solid shown on the right. Our goal is to find the exact value of the volume. We'll be using the washer method to determine the volume. When we have a horizontal axis of rotation, which is our case, we integrate with respect to x, and the integrand function is the square of big R of x minus the square of little r of x, where big R of x is the outer radius, little r of x is the inner radius. When we have a vertical axis of rotation, which does not apply here, we integrate with respect to y, and big R and little r are functions of y. To help set up the integral, it's important to always sketch a representative rectangle, which will always be perpendicular to the axis of rotation when using the washer method. So looking at the region R, let's go ahead and sketch a representative rectangle that would represent one washer of the volume when rotated about the x-axis. Let's go ahead and use this as the representative rectangle. Notice the thickness of the rectangle is delta x, which is why we integrate with respect to x. Big R of x, the outer radius, is the distance from the top of the rectangle to the axis of rotation, in this case the x-axis, which should be this vertical distance. Notice this is determined by the blue line, which is y equals x plus 4. And then the inner radius is the distance from the bottom of the rectangle to the axis of rotation, which is this distance here, which is little r of x. Notice little r of x is determined by the red line, which is y equals x plus 1. And then finally, the interval along the x-axis is x equals 0 to x equals 4, which give us the limits of integration. Let's go ahead and set up the integral. The volume v equals pi times the integral from 0 to 4 of the square of big R of x, where big R of x is determined by the line y equals x plus 4, which indicates big R of x is x plus 4, giving us the square of x plus 4, minus the square of little r of x. Little r of x is the inner radius, determined by the red line, which is y equals x plus 1. Little r of x is x plus 1, giving us the square of x plus 1 dx. And now let's evaluate this on the next slide. Let's begin by simplifying the integrand function. The square of x plus 4 is equal to x squared plus 8x plus 16. And the square of x plus 1 is equal to x squared plus 2x plus 1. And then subtracting, we have pi times the integral from 0 to 4 of x squared minus x squared is 0, 8x minus 2x is 6x, and 16 minus 1 is equal to 15, giving us 6x plus 15 as the integrand function. Next, we determine the antiderivative, but don't forget about the factor of pi. The antiderivative is 6 times x squared divided by 2, which simplifies to 3x squared plus 15x. Now we determine pi times the difference of big F of 4 and big F of 0. Big F of 4 is equal to 3 times the square of 4 plus 15 times 4 minus big F of 0 is equal to 0. Simplifying, we have pi times the quantity 48 plus 60. The exact volume is 108 pi cubic units. Which again is the exact volume of the solid when the bounded region R is rotated about the x-axis producing the solid shown here on the right. I hope you found this helpful.